So the combine has lots of parts. You can tell, I mean, there's tons of moving parts. But some of the main things that you may want to know is the header. That's the part that's on the very front. They have the snout, and that's what goes between each row. So we have a 12-row header, so it does 12 rows of corn at a time, which is also what our planter is 12 rows. So there's 13 snouts, so they each go between a row. We also have the grain tank, which you can see in the back of the combine. When I'm in the combine, you can see there's a little window right there. And then also from the outside of the combine, you can see it start to fill up. Then on the outside, there's something sticking out of the combine. That's called the auger, and that's where the corn comes out. That's how we unload it into the carts.
So I'm with the combine driver right now. Say hello.
Hello.
As a kid, my husband was lucky enough to work for his uncle on the farm. And then as an adult, he became a partner with his uncle to farm. And he's been blessed as a partner for over 20 years now.
So does it cut the stalk, or does it pull it? Does it pull the ear off?
Well, it's got two rotaries that pull the stalk down. It's got chains that gathering it. And so what it actually does, it pulls the stalk down and kind of pops the ear off. And the ears then are fed into the machine where they're thrashed. And then we have a screen that actually separates chaff from the grain. And then it's got a little elevator that elevates it up in the grain tank and deposits it, and there you have it. From the stalk off to the cob, off the cob, and in the grain tank.
So it's called a combine because it's a combination picker and thresher. Is that right?
You're probably right about that. I grew up around them and I've heard combine, never thought about it. It just is what it is, kind of like a tractor.
We have sensors up here, little lights that say, like right now, it says unload auger on. And when the grain tank is full, then this one lights up. There's lots of electronics that help. They have auto steer where it knows like right where the rows are. So that's helpful. And then how do you know like how low to put the header?
Well, you've got to set it manually to your desired height. And then can program it in to where it'll go to that height and maintain it.
Do all the corn varieties, do they need about the same height, or is it vary from variety to variety?
Normally, there's different ear placement on corn plants. There's low, medium, and high, so to speak. But for the most part, we run the header as low as possible. That way we get the stalk, more of the stalk, kind of chopped up. It's processed, and that'll help deteriorate it faster to go back in the earth for like next year's fertility. Unless you have down corn lodge, then we have to run the snout pretty much on the ground to get under it and pick it up. But hopefully we don't have that situation.
So how do you know what the moisture is?
Well, these machines nowadays have sensors located in them. And when the clean grain is coming up to the grain tank, the sensor reads the moisture level in it and it records it on the monitor over here. Of course, you have to have it calibrated. You normally have to go through a facility that has a good moisture meter, and you calibrate it accordingly. And so it just registers it on the go. And if you get into a situation where you get a crop gets too green, you may have to either go to a different field or a different area, because most grain elevators don't want grain over a certain moisture.
So is 13, 14, is that the range that we're looking for?
Normally, personally, I like 14 to 15, but the elevator probably appreciates 13 to 14 a little bit more. Now, all I have to do is blow over there and get the field heat out of it, get it back to ambient temperature, and then it's pretty much done. Just keep it storage. But when you get up to 15 or greater, then you got to blow it a lot longer and force the air through it to dry it down to about 13 to 14. A lot of corn gets drier than that before it's shipped out, but the reason I like it on the high side is because you're losing weight and moisture. So from my point of view, it's just a selling point.
Does it come off the cob any different if it's a different moisture? Is high moisture better to come off? Or?
Well, anytime you get a 15-16%, it shells very easy. Actually, the drier it gets, you've got to be concerned about watching that you don't break the kernel. So you might have to slow your machine down a little bit. Of course, this machine is it's probably about 14 years old, but it still does a good job.
So what do you like the best about driving a combine?
I like the AC probably and the cab. But when I was a youngster, we didn't have kids. And this, you ate a lot of dust during the day. So this is first class. It's real nice.
I don't think I could have been a farmer back then.
And it's a lot more comfortable. And of course we got radios, but I don't listen to radio a whole lot. I really enjoy listening to the sound of the machine so you know everything's running properly. And any little change in the noise, you know you're developing a problem, and usually I can diagnose it pretty much to where exactly it's at. It's just years and years of running a combine. I think this year is probably my 50, I'm going to tell my age on that, probably about 54 years running a combine.
He started when he was one. Now you're young.
Thank you, Nicole. But it's enjoyable, especially when you have a good crop.
I think a challenging part of driving the combine would be that you always have to keep going. You can't take a break, where the cart drivers, they get your corn, but then they can stop. They go dump it, but then they stop. And same with the truck drivers. And the combine, it's got to keep on going. Eat lunch on the go, everything on the go.
Yeah, pretty much everything. But it's not a problem. You might have to stop and take a bathroom break.
Yeah, I guess so.
That's kind of essential.
I guess so.
So the combine driver, of course, he's watching the header. He's making sure that the header is working properly and going where it's supposed to go. But he also has to keep an eye on his grain tank so that when it gets full, he can do something with that grain. He gets a little warning sound inside the cab that lets him know that it's getting close to being full. And then as he sees the cart pull up underneath the auger, then he can push a button and it starts to unload the auger into that grain cart. And then he kind of has to keep an eye on it so that he'll turn the auger off either whenever he is empty or whenever the cart is too full to hold anymore. Right here, you can see some of the corn stalks got stuck in the auger, so he had to stop and back up and see if he could get those to come loose. I don't know why they got tangled up in there, but he has to pay attention to all those little sorts of things.